What is good, guys? We are here with another suspect test. Morgan is doing another suspect test. The overused council has decided to test Mega Metagross this time. I was expecting Greninja to get tested first, especially before World Cup. Spikes are so good at the moment. Greninja basically beats all the defoggers in the tier, beats HP Fire, beats Ferrothorn with HP Fire, beats Tapu Fini with Gunk Shot, which is one of the reasons why Tapu Fini is not that good as it would be otherwise. But yeah, reasons for Metagross being suspect tested is definitely the speed buff that it got this gen, that Megas got this gen. They get the speed boost immediately, they don't need to wait one turn to get the speed. And let's just look into this threat a bit. So they're saying Metagross also had a suspect test in the middle of the last generation, but it was not deemed broken in XY. Many people believe in XY, it was an RS, right? Yeah. Many people believe that it has improved significantly during Sunmoon due to new mechanics for Mega evolving and the state of the current metagame. Metagross has an incredible offensive presence in the current metagame with high attack and a plethora of viable coverage options and strong stabs. So yeah, the only counters for Metagross, in my opinion, are like, at the moment, Mega Slowbro, because you eat up T-Punch, but if it gets boosts, even that, even you can even beat Mega Slowbro. So Quagsire is like one of the only counters, because Zen Headbutt is not that common on Metagross, and even if they run Zen Headbutt, they would have to flinch you if you run Quagsire. Skarmory is a decent check slash counter, but T-Punch and Electric Terrain can destroy that. If Rockstar up, T-Punch can potentially tweet KO, I think. Even without Electric Terrain, Mega Metagross is not a one-trick pony either, as it has superb bulk, or however you said it, on the physical side and respectable special bulk. While okay, I don't know how to pronounce this, it has base 110 speed basically, allowing it to comfortably tank hits and outspeed a majority of the metagame despite the generational speed creep. Moreover, Mega Metagross has shot to the forefront of the SMOU metagame and is viewed as a controversial threat for the aforementioned reasons. Yeah, like Mega Metagross is crazy bulk. It has like base 150 defense. It can lift Earthquake from Scarf Garchomp, from Scarf Landorus. Even with Scarf Landorus is not common, but Max Attack Landorus, it can live an Earthquake from that even. So yeah, they mention here that T-Punch and Electric Terrain and Zen and Psychic Terrain hit very hard. And yeah, Fairy types are a bit more common this gen with the Tapus added. And yeah, we have also some mons with this slower speed tiers, which also makes this mon really good. Eventually people started to think that became a bit more... What? People started to think that Metagross was potentially ban-worthy. As the metagame developed, people wondered if the amount of counterplay in a tier was sufficient or not. Mega Scissor became a bit more popular. Yeah, exactly. I was mentioning some counterplay to Metagross earlier. I didn't mention Scissor yet. And yeah, some Metagross even won HP Fire for Scissor, is what I was trying to say. I forgot earlier. Became a bit more popular as a countermeasure to Metagross, but Metagross still found itself threatening to almost every team lacking Mega Scissor, and it occasionally elected to utilize Hidden Power Fire in order to adapt to the metagame trends. I also want to say that Caesar doesn't really beat Metagross sometimes, even if it's not HP Fire Metagross, because Meteor Mash can get a boost, and Caesar's only way to hit Metagross at the moment is like Bullet Punch or U-Turn, because most Caesars don't run Sword Stance. Defog Caesar is pretty common at the moment, so if Caesar has to U-Turn out, Metagross gets a Mash boost. Like, what is the player going to do? They have to go either U-turn into their Scarfer that can potentially force out the Metagross, or they have to go back, or into like a Ninja or something. If they don't have that, they have to go back into Scizor. Metagross is at, if it gets the boost, is at plus 1, and Scizor can, is forced to switch in again, then they can get another boost. Scizor's forced to keep roosting. Metagross can just keep fishing for crits and boosts, and like Scizor doesn't even beat it that well. U-turn only does like 20% to Metagross. It's just a head calc, something along those lines. What else do we have here? Yeah, everyone can only use 4 moves, is what they're saying here. Yeah, that's the way to scout Metagross. I use the Earthquake, T-Punch, Ice Punch, Mash set a lot as that hits almost everything. Zenplatt is nice to hit packs a bit harder, but Earthquake is so Heatran doesn't wall you, and also hits opposing Metagross, which is really, really big. And otherwise, you could run Hammer Arm. If you're weak to Ferrothorn, you can run Hammer Arm on your Metagross. You can basically adapt to your team, what your team needs. It's kind of like Greninja, not that extreme, because Greninja has crazy coverage and Proline. That's a bit, it's a different story. Mega Metagross almost always runs Media Mash and one of Hammer Arm or Earthquake. Hammer Arm is not even that common. It only has like, I think it's like the sixth or seventh most used move, I think. Yeah, T-Punch, Ice Punch is basically for stuff like Skarmory, Landorus. I mean, T-Punch also hits Toxapex if you don't have Zen Headbutt. What else does it hit? Ice Punch. Yeah, Garchomp and stuff like that. It can also utilize coverage or utility moves such as T-Punch, Ice Punch and Headbutt Pursuit. Yeah, Pursuit is common on teams that only have one Steel type. So you weaken Tapalele. Tapalele takes about 55, I think, if they switch up from Pursuit. Should be Fire, Rock, Polish, Agility. It's like, yeah, that's late game Klima. And that Starfog, I've seen that even. Like, some people, that's like a wild team, but I've seen that, like, Rocks, Metagross, plus, like, Scarf Lando. Like, people expect the Lando to be Scarf, staying with, to be Rocks. Because Lando is the obvious rocker on paper, but then it's Rocks, Metagross, and Scarf Lando. And then they say there's a hard Y. It's funny, I've seen that happen. Keep in mind, you cannot assume that the Metagross user will always predict correctly, that the opponent will always pivot safely. This said, Mega Metagross will still can only use 4 moves at a time, and the moveset is often predictable based on teammates, so there's still an element of predictability. Yeah, also, Metagross has Clear Body before it Mega Evolves, so it doesn't get a drop in attack from Intimidate, which is also pretty nice for Metagross. In certain matchups, it makes Mega Metagross much less threatening offensively. Mega Metagross using mostly consistent coverage. Pokemon such as Skarmory, Fistaf, Tangrowth. Yeah, I forgot to mention Fistaf, Tangrowth. Mega Slowbro can check counter Metagross. Additionally, common choice guard users like Garchomp and fast offensive threats like a Ninja can revenge kill. Skarf Gengar not mentioned here. Skarf Gengar can also revenge it, because otherwise Gengar speed dives. I think it's a roll to kill from fall, you need like a bit chip damage on Metagross. Yeah, Greninja can force out Metagross and go for Spike, that's a big thing here. Each common Archetype? Oh, dude, I cannot speak English today. Of team has means of dealing with Metagross too. Yeah, okay, different. Some teams can deal with it better, basically. Like offensive teams with Greninja and Coco. Like Coco does a lot with T-Bolt to Metagross. Like if you have Volt Switch and Coco, you can do a lot of chip to Gross, but that's not that common. Most Coco's running like a U-turn. But yeah, if you have like five moves like that, Greninja, you can deal with it decently well. Like Greninja can switch into Mash, it takes a lot kinda, but it can switch in well on Ice Punch, so that's a play I like to make. Bring in my Gren if I have my Landorus out and I run for Rocks, they bring in a Metagross, I go Hot Ninja, but if they break that X if they click T-Punch. Ultimately, these are the pros and cons of Metagross in the SMOU metagame. So waiting out those will lead to individuals coming to an ultimate conclusion as to if they deem Metagross banworthy or not. I think, I'm really not sure. I kind of think Metagross should go, but it's like 60 to 40. I'm not 100% sure. Like, I want Greninja gone way more, because Greninja is like stupid if you're using like balanced bulky offense, like if no switch-ins. Due to the fact that Metagross has been a consistent controversial Pokemon since the dawn of the generation, and there are legitimate claims to it being a broken force in the game, the OU Teaming Council has decided that it's time for a suspect test. For this round, we are going to have two ways to qualify for voting. This is pretty much what standard, if you have gotten Rex a few times, you know how this works. You can ladder, you have 70 games and you have to get 2700 coil in those 70 games, so you basically need like 80 GXE, so you have to like win, I think you can lose like 15 to 18 games. I would not try to lose more than 15 games, and you have to get like 45 to 50 wins in those 70 games. But yeah, if you lose more than 18 games, you can basically make a new account and try over, because you're not going to be able to get Rex. Rex Garvey has gotten Rex, I think. And the Duck Trio Suspect test with a win-loss ratio of 50-20. My friend Padlop had like, I think, 19 losses. But that's kind of rare. Sometimes you cannot afford to get that many L's. I think it also depends on the players you play, how good their GXE or win-loss ratio is. And yeah, the second thing, how you can get Rex, which is really nice if you just... If you're trying to get into tournaments, Suspect Tours are really fun. There are on Smog Tours. They are gone. I think they are either weekly or are they like at the end of the Suspect? I'm not really sure. But yeah, if you win a Suspect Tour, or if you get to final, depending on how many people take place in the tour, you like I think 2 to 4 people can get Rex. Yeah, this is depending on how many people take place. Yeah, that's a really cool way to get Rex, but it's not that easy because they're like really really good players and like SPL players playing these tours and stuff. But that's a really nice way to get better at the game, to play these people, in my opinion. The Suspect test will last for approximately 2 weeks and will end on May 11th. Okay. Use this thread to discuss so you can give your opinion here. And yeah, let me guys know what you think about Metagross, and I will read out some opinions from the Overused Team Council. I don't know why I've been talking so long at the upper thing. Yeah, as we did for Formosa test, the council will give his opinion as, okay, Finch's opinion is a bit super long. I will try to make it that long. Metagross seems to have just about everything going for it. It has good bulk, okay. Decent coverage and nice speed tier. However, something being good is different from something being broken. On paper, it may seem like a perfect candidate for what Smogon generally bans, but it's important to look deeper into this. The main point I want to get at is that despite Metagross' many good traits, there are still plenty of viable counterplay measures. Defensively, many Pokemon can safely switch into Metagross. Mega Scizor, Hammer, Tangrowth, Skarmory, Alolan, and Slowbro are some of the first that come to mind. Yeah, Alolan is not common, but I've used that too for Metagross. But if they get a T-Punch Para or a Meteor Mash boost, you're not a counter anymore. I just want to say that because I've been using defensive ways to check Metagross out. Hammer, Tangrowth is pretty decent. Even with its coverage options, Metagross fails to break through heavily defensive Pokemon. Here are some Kalks. T-Punch versus Skarmory has 9. The 346, yeah, if you put Electric Terrain, that looks a bit different. Or if you get Rocks Up, or if you get a Para or a Crit, which will happen eventually. Because if you are a defensive player and you go for Roost with your Skarmory repetitively. I mean, Skarmory has Counter, but you kind of want to keep your Skarmory healthy if you need it for something else, so you're gonna spam Roost in some situations, or at least once or twice, and you can get paralyzed or crit, so it's always kind of not a 100% counterplay for Metagross. But yeah, I can understand what he's mentioning here. It's a 3-hit KO, basically, so he's saying Skarmory can switch in. And Slowbro can switch in, it does 40 to 47. Slowbro is not that good at the moment. If it'll get better, in my opinion, Greninja gets banned, but yeah, Greninja's not tested yet, so let's not talk about that. And you have Ice Punch versus Tangrowth, that's 35 to 47, and you can get chip damage off, and then you can either go for HP Fire or Sleep Powder, depending on if they have a Tapu Fini. Obviously, probably not going for Sleep Powder if they have Misty Terrain with a Tapu Fini up. Additionally, something like Land of T can 1v1 because Ice Punch isn't quite strong enough, and the same can be said for Heatran versus Hammer Arm. Yeah, but Earthquake is pretty common at the moment for Heatran, so like Heatran paired with Grassy Terrain can live an Earthquake, I guess. Or Scarfron, I've seen Scarfron. Scarfron is a nice way to check Metagross because people won't expect it and you can just kill him with Fire Blast. Another important thing to note is that there are a lot of situational switch-ins depending on Metagross coverage. If Metagross uses Hammer Arm and no Earthquake, then Jirachi pretty much waltz. Yeah, I've used Jirachi to check it, but it's just not reliable because Earthquake is so common. So Steeler Waltz, no Thunder Punch, T-Punch also pretty common. That's the most common, like Bolt Beam coverage, it's pretty common. Lanrus Waltz, no Ice Punch. Rotom is pretty decent Metagross check, because then Headbutt is not common at the moment. Gastrion, Quagsire, Walnose, and Headbutt. Ferrothorn, Waltz, no Hammer Arm. Yeah, Ferrothorn is a pretty decent check, because you get chip damage off. You can scout for Hammer Arm by going to Lanrus, but then again, they can predict that. And so forth. Metagross really just isn't as offensively devastating as people make it out to be. I can kind of understand what he's saying, but let's go ahead and read more. Offensively, there are definitely some good countermeasures to Metagross, whether it be revenge killing or winning only one. The best revenge killers are Greninja, Duck Trio, Oh yeah, Ground Yumdagi is pretty nice, but many other, to kill it, or is it just Focus Sash? But many other Pokemon can revenge it if it's slightly less than full. Some of these include Scarf Garchomp, Scarf Gengar, and Tapu Koko. As for Pokemon that pretty much always 1v1 but are not traditional revenge killers or switch-ins, there are plenty. Just going through all your relevant Pokemon. Charizard, Marowak, Morwile, Mew, Mimikyu. Mew is cool at the moment because it checks the new outcome Mega Mansion that came out new. Mimikyu is nice because it's disguise. Sableye, if it's Fist Def. Or it can whisper, so it can beat the 1v1 basically, yeah. Volcarona, yeah, the bulky Volcarona can beat it also pretty well, because Earthquake only does like 30%, 35%, and you can get a burn if they go for a mash, T-punch, something like that, trying to hit something else on your team. Also, I like to run bulky Charizard with like 120 HP to lift Thunder Punch always from full. Shoutouts to Bengay, that's a Bengay spread. I won't delve too much into this, but another important point is that Manowar is extremely prone to being worn down, whether by entry hazards, a rough skin, iron bobs, rocky helmet, or just a lack of recovery overall. It rarely is going to stay perfectly healthy for a while. I completely agree with this, but my friend TK has used Wish Pass into Metagross in the tournament. It was pretty deadly, because his Metagross that usually gets worn down by Helmet Landorus, it was at 60 or 50 and he could Wish Pass into it, burst pretty deadly, and I think he like almost 6-0'd with that Metagross. I mean, it was not like SPL Finals or something, it was just a tournament game like in Facebook group, but still. What else am I trying to mention here? I completely agree it's getting worn down, but in the process, while it gets worn down, it does a lot of damage to the opponent if you predict correctly, but that depends on prediction, so cannot say anything against this is true. And all the RS Metagross was also suspected, and for many of the same reasons. It's true that the instant speed is a notable buff, but it has not changed all too much, especially in regards to direct switch-ins and revenge killers. Additionally, to the argument about the terrains of the new fairies don't affect the metagame all too much. The terrains only last 4 turns of tap after Tapu is sent in if they die on a switch-in and only boost or weaken one move at a time. They also affect other Pokemon just as much as they do Metagross. Also called Fable's presence and auras is just about equal to all of the Tapus combined. So this fairy prevalence argument should not be used here at all. Okay, that's true. Clefable was so common in auras and it's not used anymore. It's so rare, it's still used with rocks sometimes, but it's not common at all. I'm sure we can all agree that the decision made in auras was the right one. I know how hasty people can jump to conclusions of something being broken, and I'd hate to see a rash decision being made here. I can agree with this. I thought at the beginning of the gen that Tapu Lele was pretty stupid, but I don't think that anymore. Faramosa was only banned a few weeks ago, and SM is evolving at a rapid pace. I'm not totally convinced Metagross should remain in OU forever, but I'm also not convinced right now it's the time to ban it, especially with how fast the SM metagame shifts. If Metagross is still an issue after some real settling time, then I'm entirely open to a resuspect in the future. And yes, being patient is unbelievably crucial when these tiering decisions shape metagames for years to come. I was personally opposed to having the suspect test done at this time, because I don't believe now is the time to ban Metagross if there ever is one. Yeah, I would say let's ban Greninja first, but I will play the suspect as Lazar and we'll see how the latter is, and then I will form my opinion. I'm really not that sure at the moment. I will only look into other opinions if they are shorter. There's a Skype call, I will answer that later. Okay, Blood's opinion is really long, so I will just look at the end. If Metagross is banned, I believe that the OUT will undergo positive metagame development, because a greater variety of team building will be able to thrive. So he's basically saying you have to run like Scizor, I think. I haven't read his thing, but I assume that you have to run specific things for Metagross is what he's saying. But you can say that for a lot of mons. But yeah, I haven't read the entire thing. Let me look at Blunder's opinion. Oh, Blunder's is not in there, okay. Not in yet. Brofist. Gen 6 to Gen 7 has been way too kind to Metagross. The changes at the speed boost, I think, is what he meant. The introduce of some of the new Pokemon that roam free in OU, the Tapus, as well as general metagame trends benefit Metagross to the point where it has been pushed over the edge. Metagross sports a fantastic combination, or did he mean combination of traits? It has great raw power and a good offensive move pool, which makes it hard to switch into safely. It also sits in an above average speed tier of base 110 thanks to the new mechanics, and has good bulk. I don't know how to pronounce this word. For an offensive Pokemon, this makes revenge killing it a difficult task, even for Pokemon with Choice Scarf, Garchomp, and Dougie, who despite having Stab super effective Earthquake to hit it with, require a good amount of prior damage to ensure a KO. I think Dougie's Earthquake does around 70% to Metagross, and Garchomp does like 85. I'm not really sure about that, but there's something along those lines. Metagross, it does something in the 80s, I'm sure about that, but I'm not sure about the exact number. Metagross is an incredibly restrictive force on the team building aspect of SMOU. Coverage options such as Zen Headbutt, Ice Punch, T-Punch, Hammer Arm, Earthquake, Pursuit, and Bullet Punch all complement its main stat medium mesh beautifully. It also has access to less common support options such as Stealth Rock, Rock Polish. This means that it is a largely flexible and customizable Pokemon, able to adapt its moveset to the metagame around it to fulfill the needs of the team it is on. Many Metagross users have even started to run HP Fire to circumvent Mega Scissor, a Pokemon that is universally recognized as the best Metagross counter in the game. All of this without even mentioning how other counterblade Metagross is only a medium mash attack rate or then headbutt flinch away from being muscle passed. Exactly. Medium mash has a 20% chance to boost the attack, and it feels like 50% in my opinion. If you've played a decent amount of SMOU, you'll know what I mean. Exactly. For these and other reasons, I believe that Metagross is simply too good for OU and plan to vote in favor of its ban. Good god. Wait, this is Finchinator? I thought I just read Finchinator's opinion. Finchinator? Blood? Oh, I read ABR's opinion earlier. I'm sorry, I mixed it up. I read ABR's opinion. I thought I was reading Finchinator because Finchinator made the post and I saw his picture here. Yeah, my bad, guys. What is Finchinator saying? I will just look at the end. He said it's too much for the metagame. So we can see the trend here. I think three people said ban and ABR was not sure. I think three people were leaning towards ban. But yeah, and Dragon's opinion is not in there yet. PDC is. He says at the moment it does not transcend the boundary of strong offensive pick into the field of outright broken. I don't know how to pronounce that exactly, but he thinks it's not outright broken. Oh yeah, especially what, I don't know if it was ABR who said that, but the metagame is evolving pretty fast. Like, it's changing all the time is what I'm trying to say. We get all the new megas, like, I can't wait to get Mega the Yancy and Mega Lopunny. So I can really understand what ABR is saying, that the metagame is changing still. So, and one mon will always be super good as Greninja, so I think we should have tested it first, like I said, but yeah. Let me look at TDK. The amount of counterplay Metagross has is incredibly limited. The strain it presents, particularly in team building, make it ridiculous to apply. I think this means apply. Never mind. I don't know what this word means. I've never heard that word. I'm German for you guys who don't know. So my English is okay, it's not the best. This test isn't remotely similar to the Aura's test for Mega Metagross, as Metagross only experienced buffs with the release of Sun and Moon. Between the Mega Speed boost, granting Mega Metagross 110 base speed, the turn it Mega evolves, terrains, basically all terrains benefit Metagross. So the Psychic Terrain means Ash Greninja can't Water Shuriken you, but Ash Greninja outspeeds you, never mind, forget that. It means Mega Mobile can Sucker Punch you. The Psychic Terrain means that. So Bishop would not be able to Sucker Punch you. Grassy and Psychic Terrain. In Grassy Terrain, you get Recovery Metagross if you switch on Tapu Bulu. Electric Terrain boosts its Thunder Punch. Oh yeah, Psychic Terrain obviously also boosts Zen Headbutt. And Misty Terrain means you can switch it in on Scald from Toxapex without fearing to get burned. Yeah, okay. And Decline and Viability of Mega Scissor. I feel Scissor's viability hinges, or I don't know how to pronounce that, on its ability to beat Mega Metagross and only that. With all this considered, I intend to vote to ban Metagross. So I think four people on the council were leaning towards ban and two were not sure. Or PDC said he doesn't want it gone at the moment. But yeah, TDK says he, the threat is As per usual, the server will be closed for the first 24 hours, and afterwards I'll edit this post by suspect 2 informations and announce it in the thread when things are determined. Till then, happy lettering. So I will link, I already like this post, yeah. I will link this down below in the description. If you're interested in joining suspect 2, just check out this TDK post here. And yeah, let me know what you guys think about Metagross. I lean towards ban, but I will have to ladder a bit and see how the ladder is without Metagross. I completely agree with some of the opinions in the overused council that it opens up some, you can make some changes in your team building. Sun Moon is such a crazy metagame. You cannot prepare for everything, you have to be weak to something, and the ones that come to mind at first is when you build, you're like, I need a Metagross check or something to outspeed and revenge it. And like the mons that come to mind that you have to have something for is like Greninja, Metagross, I don't know, that's for me that's the two mons that come to mind the most when I team build. I also think about stuff like Coco, so most of the time I throw on a Tangros on my teams because it checks Ash, Greninja and Tapu Koko really well, and just in general really good pivot, and Sun and Moon beats Feeny 1v1, even though Feeny's not that common at the moment. So but yeah, I don't want to make this video too long. Hope you guys will have fun lettering for the suspect test. Let me know if you are trying to get Rex, or if you don't really care about the suspect test, or if you like Metagross has to go, or if you like I have to save Metagross, or if you still have to form, if you still have to try out how the metagame is without Metagross, you don't know yet if you weren't banned. And peace out, friends, and I will see you the next day with some OUPL coverage. Peace out, and some Shot on Lives, and some probably next week with the OST finals between ABR and Bengay, which is pretty hyped. Oh damn, I just spoiled if you didn't see the Bengay game yet. You probably have seen it before. Peace out, friends.